here. I was turned out of the class. I replied crying. Why? She asked me then. Because I am a Hindu, I said. I was 6 years old then, and I didn't know what being a Hindu was. I was thrown out of the mandatory religion class held in school. Because as now I see it as, I was cursed, as I was a Hindu. My father requested the teacher to take me in and teach me too. I was happy, happy to attend the class and happy to recite. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alamin. I was 16 years old as I fell in love with him. I told him I love him as he looked straight in my eyes. He told me he loved me too, with a twinkle in his eyes. Jahangir his name and Maya mine. But we didn't think about that much as we melt in each other's arms. I was 20 years old as I shouted the name of my brother. I asked him to take us someplace safe, because at the moment we weren't safe. In that place, in that house, between that crowd and on the soil. He stretched his legs on the cot with laziness and carelessness, ignoring what I said. I'm a Hindu girl in an Islamic state. Please take me somewhere, some place where I'll be safe. Angrily, I left to meet Jahangir. I wanted to tell him how I feel. He excitedly tells me that he's planning to leave that God-forsaken country and shift to USA permanently. Not once did he try to ask me, what will I do after he leaves? I shouted, I cried, and I threatened them I would leave. They agreed and packed, and we said, and we leave. New city means new state, but the color of blood still the same. The ashes, the burns, the humanity still in flames. We are human before we are Hindu, my atheist father said. This is my country, this is my motherland, and I am not leaving this no matter what happens. My mother stopped applying sindoor in the middle partition of her hair. My father wears a pajama instead of dhoti. And we say pani instead of gel. My brother was circumcised, you know, in case. And we don't pray or chant out loud, you know. The news shows it was because of what Hindus did in India. But why are we being punished here? My cousin was abducted last night from her house. It scared my father. He made his mind and said, let's leave. Let's go to India. I happily hugged my mother as I heard a knock on the door. Mashima is us, they say, and my mother opens the door. They start breaking the stuff in house, one by one. I hide behind the curtain as one of them noticed, then grabs me by my hair and push me in the vehicle they came in. I look behind as I finally leave my home.